About an hour before the blast, gunfire by Taliban forces triggered panic among the crowd. The crowd was seen fleeing from gunfire near Kabul International Airport. The Taliban has been firing regularly into the air to control the crowds of Afghans at Kabul Airport. Soon after this, two suicide bombers and a gunman killed at least 100 people. 13 US troops died in the blast and more than 140 people were left injured.
Taliban now has access to over $85 billion worth of American military equipment. That includes 75,000 vehicles, over 200 airplanes and helicopters, over 600,000 small arms and light weapons. The Taliban now has more Black Hawk helicopters than 85% of the countries in the world.
In a speech in Washington, former U.S. Navy reservist Jim Banks revealed shocking details of Taliban's war chest. According to Jim Banks, the Taliban has access to weapons, tanks, and aircraft worth $85 billion at its disposal. Jim Banks said that the military equipment left behind includes 75,000 vehicles, 200 aircraft, and helicopters, and 600,000 small arms and light weapons. The Taliban now has more Black Hawk helicopters than 85% of the world. The United States lost some of its brave hearts in the dastardly blast in the vicinity of the Kabul International Airport. To mark the loss of life and mourn the death of these U.S. forces, Jen Psaki said U.S. flags across the country will be flown at half-staff until August 30th. The blast came hours after Western officials warned of a major attack, urging people to leave the airport. But that advice went largely unheeded by Afghans desperate to escape the country in the last few days of an American-led evacuation before the U.S. officially ends its 20-year presence on August 31st. Psaki said, the U.S. has no information that the Taliban was aware of ahead of time or took part in the attack. Taliban spokesperson Zabihullah Mujahid condemned the Kabul airport blast and said that U.S. forces were responsible for the security of the area where the twin blasts took place. The spokesperson said, the Islamic Emirate strongly condemns the bombing of civilians at Kabul airport, which took place in an area where U.S. forces are responsible for security. The Islamic Emirate is paying close attention to the security and protection of its people.